COPD is a disease that affects the lungs in the human body, and it is a mechanism where you have two things happening. One is you destroy the actual lung tissue, and then we call it emphysema, and you also develop a thickening of the tubes that lead the air to the lungs, you know, making it difficult to get air in and out. The whole complex of COPD and emphysema is mostly tobacco related, but obviously you can have it from secondhand smoking, you can have other reasons causing that destruction, and it's usually progressive. It's in the top 10 reasons for mortality in the United States, and in the top 10, the only one that's actually rising. So people have more success in treating cancer, heart disease, and stroke than we have had in approaching emphysema. The symptoms are usually cough, lots of sputum production, and with time, shortness of breath. This becomes the most disabling problem these people deal with. You and I don't really have to think about breathing, it just happens. Very rarely are you reminded that the lungs don't want to support you doing more exercise. It's really something that you don't even have to think about at all. Patients with emphysema are very different. They often think about every breath. They sometimes have to make decisions. Do I chew and swallow, or do I breathe? So even basic activities of daily living can become a problem as you become progressively more short of breath. And this disabling symptom is something that is very hard to treat. The only treatment medically that has been shown to improve survival is still oxygen. All other therapies, and these include medications like prednisone, antibiotics, inhalers, are aimed to make you feel better with varying success, but generally have not shown to actually improve your survival. So medical treatment is very unsatisfying for the provider as well as for the patient. And one thing that has come along over the last couple of years is a surgical treatment called lung volume reduction surgery that in a small set of patients can improve your life expectancy and can improve your symptoms, but it is fraught with a significant morbidity and mortality rate. Well, the most exciting thing for us are trials that try to imitate the results of lung volume reduction surgery with the improvement in shortness of breath and hopefully improvement of survival without the problems associated with that, without the general anesthesia, without the opening of the chest, the actual surgery, and with that the potential risk for death or disabling problems. And this is the whole field of endoscopic lung volume reduction. We've been active with trials for quite a few years now at this institution and are quite encouraged by the early results that have been available in that field.